Welcome to yet another episode of Beyond the Screen right here on WTV. I'm your ever faithful host, Redempta Oburu. And today I have a very famous person here with me. Yes, Mr. Gerald.
Yes.
How are you?
When you say faithful, you mean? When you say faithful means?
Like I'm always there.
Ah, okay.
Yes.
But yes, thank you very much for having me.
Yes,
yes.
I'm very delighted to have you here
thank
with me.
Thank you very much.
Yes, Mr. Gerald.
Yes.
You're very good at being somebody else. Maybe that's the best way to put it.
Yeah, I mean, I'm an actor. I'm a casting director. I'm a blogger as well.
Mm.
I'm basically an artsy person. Yeah. Not just an actor, I'm an award-winning actor.
Wow.
I must put that in there.
Hey,
I'm an award-winning
award?
Actor.
Lingana ni gani?
Hmm. Well, I have 3 awards.
Mm-hmm.
One for Best Supporting Actor in a TV series for a role I played in a series called Stay.
Stay?
Yes, uh-huh. I was playing a character called Nico, and I won Kalasha Awards last year, 2014.
Oh, congratulations.
Thank you very much. And then last year as well, I won an award for blogging as the Best African Blogger.
Mm.
You know, Best African Film Blogger at the African Film Development Awards.
Wow.
Which were in Arusha, Tanzania as well.
Mm-hmm.
And the other award was for my blog as well, Actors.co.ke. It won Best Niche Market Blog.
Wow.
Best African Niche Market Blog at the African Blogger Awards.
And what made you start this blog?
Well, it's really a long story. I joined acting 5 years ago,
mm-hmm.
you know, after leaving my daytime job and I got into acting. And mm-hmm. when I got into acting, I saw a gap in the acting industry.
Mm.
You know, basically, there wasn't readily and easily accessible information
mm.
about our acting industry, about auditions, for example. You know, we as actors, auditions are our interviews.
Yeah.
So if you're not in the industry to get to know about this information, someone who's outside, mm. someone in Western, for example, who doesn't know how to get, you know, audition information because they're not in Nairobi,
mm-hmm.
They're left out.
Yeah.
Okay. Sure. So I felt, you know, how about to start something simple as a blog, a website, mm-hmm. a simple website that will just simply, you know, put information about the acting industry,
uh-huh.
so that anyone, wherever they are, mm-hmm. who have, you know, access to internet, and now it's everyone, right?
Mm-hmm.
They can just log into actors.co.ke
wow.
and get information about the acting industry.
Wow, and you give yeah. a lot of information, so...
Yes,
uh-huh.
yes.
Okay, and I heard you say that you left your daytime job.
Yes.
To join acting.
Yes.
What were you doing recently?
By the time I was joining acting, I was the IT billing manager at a company called Flashcom Limited.
Wow.
Yes.
And you decided to leave that for acting?
Well, yes, I have my reasons. I mean, things weren't really going well at the office. The company wasn't really doing very well. And
uh-huh.
then this opportunity came,
uh-huh.
which I took it up gladly. And I've never regretted
this. You've never looked back.
Yeah, I've never looked back. I mean, mm-hmm. I went to school to learn IT,
uh-huh.
computing and internet systems. So that's basically my main line of work.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So I got employed after that. I think I worked for like 4 years
mm-hmm.
after finishing campus. And then, yeah.
Opportunity,
like this opportunity came and mm-hmm. and nikangalia kazi, nikangalia acting, something which I've loved to do, like mm-hmm. something I really wanted to do for a very long time, you know, ever since I was a kid, I was acting.
Ah.
From nursery to primary to high school plays to, you know, name it. So yeah, opportunity came and I took it because I saw it as, you know, there's my chance, so mm. let me grab it.
Okay,
yeah.
And for most people, when you decide to join things like acting, people
yeah.
don't take it seriously.
Yeah.
So what kind of challenges have you had from your parents
yeah.
and continuing on to your friends and other people?
Ooh. Well, I mean, the biggest regret I have about acting is the fact that I didn't start it earlier.
Mm-hmm.
You know, after high school, I wanted to pursue acting further,
mm-hmm.
but I had, you know, my mom thought acting was a hobby, it wasn't something serious, you know.
Mm-hmm.
So, end of summer. You know, go do something else. You can act, but die if you want to act or something, you know, like, you know, like who does acting for a living,
mm-hmm.
you know. So I went to campus and I schooled and, you know, after I grew up and had the right to make my own choices and decisions, I took acting, you know, back.
Acting.
Yeah.
Uh-huh.
But I guess that's the biggest, you know, challenge like we artists have in general.
Mm-hmm.
We are not at the point where many people see it as a career.
Mm-hmm.
It's slowly changing. I can mm-hmm. slowly see people literally doing it. I mean, I, for example,
mm-hmm.
have been surviving on acting for the past 5 years,
mm-hmm.
you know, as an actor. Mm-hmm. I've been paying my rent, you know, living off acting.
Yeah, living
I'm not a millionaire yet. You know,
mm-hmm,
I don't
yeah.
have my limousine and, you know, my house by the beach. But you can survive off it.
You can survive
You can
off
make
it,
a yeah. career out of it and a profession out of it. So, yeah, mm-hmm. I usually encourage people mm-hmm. to... you know, follow your dreams. Like, if acting is what you want to do, like, you know, just, but do it right. Like, mm-hmm. do it with the right information, because it's not easy.
Mm-hmm.
It's a journey. It's not a destination. Like, yeah. It's a process.
It's a process.
Yeah, I mean, I've had challenges. I've been broke.
Mm-hmm.
You know, because I could leave a rent at some point. And they say, mother, I was, but mommy, but she's my biggest fan now. Yeah. I mean, she really appreciates seeing me on TV and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. But yeah, it's not easy,
mm-hmm.
but it's doable, especially if you really have the passion for it and the right mm-hmm. attitude towards
it. You can be able to make it.
Yes.
So if you remove acting from Gerald, who can you say you are?
Oof. Who is Gerald? Gosh. Mm-hmm. That's a hard question. I mean, I keep changing my definition of who I am every single year and mm-hmm. every single day.
Mm-hmm.
As of now, Gerald is, you know, a free spirit, wild, crazy, mm-hmm. fun-loving, social mm-hmm. person who, you know, just loves to be out there.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I'm just that guy, that life of the party kind of person.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, and if you remove acting, basically, I don't know.
You're nothing.
Like, not nothing. Uh-huh. I mean... But yeah, I mean, acting is me.
Ah,
it's my life.
Mm-hmm.
It's my life at the moment. Mm-hmm. At the moment, yeah. I don't know about tomorrow,
mm-hmm.
but as of now, acting, it's what I wake up and sleep.
Thinking, so in short, what you're saying is that you don't do any other thing apart from acting.
I'm like in the film industry fully. Yes.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
Oh wow.
Yeah.
That is nice.
Yeah.
Okay. In general, there's one thing I want to know. What general do you think about the industry in Kenya when it comes to acting? You've mentioned a few things about the way maybe what do you think about the curriculum that you have in schools? Do you think acting should be incorporated?
Well, I was sad to hear that arts and craft was removed from the syllabus some time back.
But arts and craft, I don't think it
that's where it begins. That's where you start nurturing people to, you know, pursue their art, and people to start discovering
their talent.
Exactly. I mean, if it wasn't for my national school teacher, primary teacher, for example, a guy called Mr. Otunga, I remember very well from class 3 or 4, who, you know, was my art and craft teacher the same at that time, and later on went to be my acting teacher as well, to guide me towards acting.
Yeah.
I don't think I would have had the same passion the way I
do
right now.
That you do have right now.
You know, so art and craft is a really important syllabus in school. However, when you come to high school, for example, you have the drama festivals and you know, the solo verses and choral verses, interdenominational, I don't know what competitions. It's been a long while since I was in high school. But those competitions, those are really nice to nurture and groom people into becoming the actors of the future. Now, the acting in high school is different from the acting in, you know,
the
commercial. Yeah, exactly. Mm-hmm. Because, you know, mostly high school acting is theater acting. And then if you want to become an actor on screen, you have to like change and learn a few things here and there, you know. But yeah, I guess from a very young age, teachers and, you know, parents and whatnot should try and nurture their children, especially if they notice that the children, you know, because me, I was a bad kid.
Other than school,
I was expelled from school. I was just that guy.
You were expelled from school.
I was that guy, and yeah.
No, that's a story I'd like to hear.
I was a bully. I was striking somewhere. I'm not saying it's a good thing.
Yeah,
I'm just saying I was that guy whose mind and character wasn't really
at the right place at the right time.
Exactly. I always felt as if I was the old one out. You know, as that guy. And it's these old children that parents try to ignore and think when to buy a son, that have something in them that you just don't know.
Yeah.
It could be that we are rebelling because we don't want to conform to certain rules and society, things, you know, that don't make sense to us. But that's the artist in you.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'd like to know which schools you went to, because now...
Well, I was born and raised in Mombasa.
Uh-huh.
So I went to Mombasa, first of all, a school called M.M. Shah Primary.
M.M. Shah.
It's Likuwa Kiindi. And then class 6, I came to Nairobi Consolata Primary.
Consolata?
Yes. That time my mom had been given a transfer to Nairobi to work here.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So I went to Consolata. Then I went back to Coastal Kenyatta High School, Matate.
Mm-hmm.
And that's where I got expelled.
And then, you got expelled because of what?
It's a long story.
Or you were acting or something.
It's the common story of children striking because of bad food and bad teachers. And I used to call that school prison, man. I mean, back then, that Kenyatta High School was just... Anyway, yeah. So we got expelled, and I went to a school called Kajiado High.
Kajiado High,
So I finished high school in Kajiado.
High. And IT, you spoke about doing IT. You did it in university.
Yes. I mean, IT was something that also really fascinated me.
Mm-hmm.
I loved computers from really, I was also, you know, whenever I see gadgets, I'd be interested to find out how they work. Exactly. I was a geek, actually. Because I really passed. I mean, I got second upper class honors with honors.
Which university?
University of Huddersfield. It's in UK.
So you were in UK for your...
I went for my final paper exam in UK.
Wow, that's nice.
But we were doing it locally.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Okay, let's get back to acting.
Yeah.
I'd like to know which films have you acted in and which ones have you directed?
Where to begin? Which films?
Mm-hmm.
I think around about 15 movies now.
15 movies?
12 to 15 movies now, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Others are series, others are movies. They just
end. Yeah. These are just films, movies peke yake. Uh-huh. Yeah, I started with House of Lungula.
Nguo zangu ziko wapi?
Where are my clothes?
In the bathroom. Where are mine?
Sijui, where were they?
In the bathroom.
Ah, I threw them away.
Why?
Because I'm the maid.
Mm-hmm.
I think that's the one that many people had heard of.
Mm-hmm.
As of Lungula, then there was Fundamentals as well.
Where's our coffee? It should be here waiting for us.
It's coming right up.
Cigarettes, please.
Cigarettes? I'm sorry, Mr. Joseph. We don't have any smokers in the house.
And how is that my problem, eh? Unless you want me to leave.
No. Fiona can rush and get you some cigarettes. Fiona, can you go get Mr. Joseph some cigarettes? Step into the trap, I don't mind a little girl. Tell him step into the trap. I got this, I got that. When you step into the trap, find his keeper on the dash. Tell him step into the trap. Put in work. Hey, what gonna change?
No, sir. You're not paying me, remember?
What's your jinga kuna bisha mbele ya watu? Madam, what gonna... Do you have 200 shillings?
Of course.
Get that pack of cigarettes and keep the change. Chop chop.
And then the rest are TV films, and they are on Africa Magic, actually. Mm-hmm. If you can watch my Africa Magic. The list is long. I mean, I have a website called GeraldLangiri.com where I put all my work I've done on my website. So you can check them out there, yeah. But
Zingine
mm-hmm. tazitakumbuka sahi.
Na zingine local. Basi mention at least the local ones that you've
They're
done.
All local. I mean, they're all Kenyan films. They haven't, mm-hmm. haven't done an international film yet,
mm-hmm.
you know. And I'm looking forward to that.
Wow.
When I say Masiya Fika Bado, like, I still have targets and things that I want to do.
Mm-hmm. And which one are you doing at this particular point?
I just finished a short film called Happy Anniversary.
Mm-hmm.
We shot like I think a week or two weeks ago.
Mm-hmm.
It's a short film though, so I talk about mm-hmm. and another film called The Cast.
The Cast.
Yes. And I mean, they're interesting because they play characters which many people have not seen mm-hmm. me play, you know, because mm-hmm. people are used to me being this serious guy, always in a suit,
mm-hmm.
you know, like the way I started off in Mashtaka.
Mm-hmm.
I was a lawyer in Mashtaka in a suit. I went to Mali.
Serious guy, huh?
Yeah, in a suit as well as a lawyer. I went to a program called Maisha as a cop, you know, so I've always been playing serious roles.
Mm-hmm.
And then House of Lungula came, which kind of shifted my character. People started saying, okay, this guy can also play funny characters.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, as of Lungula Fundamentals, then I went to Papa Shirandula as well,
mm-hmm.
as you know, some rich Nigerian guy, you know. And then there was a series on Citizen TV called Santalal, where mm-hmm. again I became a cop.
So like
this characters. Mm-hmm. But now these two films I did, I was playing evil characters.
Evil.
Wow. Yes, evil.
Like the Niger evil.
No. You see, Niger acting, Kenya acting is totally different. I think mm-hmm. Nigeria have their own style of doing things, which mm-hmm. is overly dramatic, and it's accepted in them. But
in them, yeah,
but it's not for me. I wouldn't call that good acting,
mm-hmm.
you know. So by evil, I mean like I'm playing a bad guy,
which
normally doesn't really happen because I'm usually the funny, nice guy, or you know, the authority guy, but not like evil guy.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Not about it, because like, you know, in one film I kill someone,
mm-hmm.
I kill my wife and the boyfriend, I find them cheating and like walk here and I kill
but
them.
But you wouldn't do that in real life,
I don't know, maybe I would.
Ah! be arrested when I get in the show.
I don't know, because you see, this film brought that aspect of what if you woke
up one day and,
you find your wife with your gym instructor in bed.
Yeah, or your husband.
Or, exactly.
Yeah, for me, you know, I wouldn't have a wife.
Well, when I walk into my house and find my wife with, you know, with the gym instructor, yeah. How would you react as that? You know, like, so, and that's the power of film. Like, like film puts you at a place, not only I as an actor, where it puts me at a place where I get to reflect about life and the things I'll do in life, but also the audiences and, you know, it creates this situation about life and talks about life in ways where, you know, normally wouldn't really happen, but what if it happened that way? What would you do, you know? And that's the power of film.
Wow.
Yeah.
Yeah, we'll take a short break and we'll be right back with Gerald.
I am a firm believer in the age-old maxim that familiarity breeds contempt. That is why I don't get over familiar with my employees, both at home and at work.
Nimefanya kazi ya domestic engineer kwa miaka mingi sana. Kwa hivyo niko na experience kwa hii njombi yangu kabisa. Ili usurvive kwa hii njombi, kuna kuangana rule. Rule number one, usiwahi fanya mother a threatened kwa position yake kwa nyumba. Hata ukikuwa tu kamsupu, unajifanya, unajifunga kakitamba, unakafunga. Eh? Ule hazi usiwahi mzarimia sana.
I have seen many of my friends succumb to the wiles of the women employees.
Ukitaka kufutua njomba, cheza na mbona ya madhe.
And that is why I keep my relationship strictly professional.
Na ndo maana, sitawai kalimbia mbona ya mtu.
And that is the secret to a successfully employer-employee relationship.
Welcome back. You're watching Beyond the Screen with me, Redempta Oburu, and I'm here with Mr. Gerald. Or Gerald. Would you prefer Gerald?
Ni Gerald.
No,
it depends how far you are from England.
And me, I'm very far.
Clearly, England iko huku. England iko huku.
Yes.
Ni Gerald.
Yeah, Gerald.
Spelled with a G, but it's pronounced as J.
Oh, whoa.
Gerald.
I'll get closer and closer to the Indian person. Mimi, I'm going to talk after tumemalizana na hapa. Yes. So I'd like to know your acting career.
Yes.
How did it start?
Yeah. Like I said before, I was working in an office. And this is my story about my professional acting career. Otherwise, my acting career started when I was really young. From church plays, you know, from playing baby Jesus. I was an ugly baby Jesus, but I was baby Jesus all the same.
It doesn't matter to be an actor anyway, so.
You know, so from primary school, nursery school, all the way to high school. But now my professional acting career, which we call commercial acting, you know, when you act for a living. Started 5 years ago, 2011. And I was chatting with a friend of mine online. Her name is Irene Ayimba. She's also an actress. She told me about this new show starting called Mashtaka. And they're looking for someone who can speak good Swahili and looks like a lawyer and whatnot. And since she know me, I'm from Coast. And my Swahili is really good. It was really good. Wabara umenyaribu sahi, man. Sometimes kuyaribika, lakini sawa. Niko hapo bado. Yeah, so I went to try out for Mashtaka, and then, I got picked. And then from there, that's when now things just started properly. And that's the thing about the acting industry. Like, you really have to, like, have one leg inside it to get to know of you know, opportunities and stuff like that. Because when I was in Mashtaka, that's what I heard about Mali, you know, auditions. And you know, and I went for Mali audition as well. And I guess I impressed the judges, and I was taken in as a lawyer as well. And yeah, and after that, I've just been doing series and series and series. Yeah,
pole. Yeah, so it's true what they say. Just have one foot in.
Yes.
And then the other one will follow.
Yeah, but you see, I keep saying acting is biashara. It's not just about having one foot inside. It's also about how you push yourself. How you push your career, how you push your product. And I being the product of my business.
Okay, so you started with Mashtaka, Ukafuata. And which point can you say was your highest point? Like your peak penye, sasa uli, watu walanza kujua Gerald.
Papa Shirandula.
Papa Shirandula.
When I acted as Mr. Araka Smart, I was on Papa for, I think, 10 episodes only. But it's 10 episodes, which till now, I still meet people who, you know, recognize me from Aya. Papa, Mr. Araka Smart, Abadegani, Yudua. Like, it really changed my acting career because it really put me out there now. Mashtaka, not so much because I was there for, I think, 5 episodes. Mali, I was there for many episodes, yes, but I guess many people don't watch NTV. I don't know how true that is, but I believe Citizen is like the most watched station in Kenya. Mm-hmm. I believe so, because from me appearing on Citizen on Papa Shangla,
oh, things just have,
yeah, mm-hmm, people started recognizing who I am. You know, more interest came from advertisers and stuff like that. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Wow.
Yeah.
And what can you say is the most challenge, like, in this career of yours? Like, the most senior neza kasema, hii ni number one. If they can just remove this, I think life will be very swift.
One, the opportunities are not that many, you know. So getting opportunities is kind of difficult, you know. I'd love to be working every day of my life, or working every single month, and then nipumzike mwezi mmoja, then I'm back on set. But that's not the case.
Ah.
You know, unless now you are on a show which is running for long. For example, Mali was 1 year.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, I was on set almost every single day for almost a year.
Mm-hmm.
So that was really good. But opportunities are not that many. And by the time you get a really good project coming along, it takes time.
Ah.
And then at the same time, the payment is not that, I don't know, the payment is not that much. I know everyone complains about money.
Money, yeah, but then yeah,
it's not really, you can make a career out of it, but you know, before that big break comes,
you see,
you asked me about my big break, and I said my big break in terms of visibility as an actor, which is really important.
Yeah.
But in not terms of financial wise, I'm still waiting for my big break. I'm waiting for that movie in Kafunga to Ivy.
Okay. And do you think that's why many people don't go into acting?
Many people are not patient about it.
Yeah.
That's the thing. Many people are not patient about it. Wanataka waingie and then waanze ku pata pesa
sa hiyo hiyo hiyo,
and the fame then and it takes time.
Lakini with this economy bana.
It takes time. But bana sema it's biashara, like, you know, with any business you have to have your capital, you have to invest in it, you know, you have to buy whatever you need to buy to make your business look good, and then you have to give it a grace period.
Yeah.
Now in the acting world, the grace period is 5 years. Yes,
after
5 years, that's when you start now, you know, you now start minting money back. And this is my 5th year, so I'm hoping my fortunes will change. Because I have the fame, and I'm just waiting for the fortunes.
The fortunes are coming.
Amen.
They're on the way.
Amen.
Yes. So,
amen.
What are your future plans? Baro taendelea to acting until death do you part with
it's
acting.
It's my wish to do so.
Uh-huh.
I mean, I really love to act for the rest of my life. But I'm trying to get myself into directing. I want to produce something on my own as well, you know. I'm trying to spread my
your wings
exactly, and get more opportunities out there, because I mean, it would be nice if I could survive as an actor, and I wish that is the case, because if that is the case, I'd be happy, because I love acting so much. It's in me. But yeah, I'm trying to get myself into doing other stuff, like directing and producing as well. Yeah.
And just as a by the way, do you think acting and family, do they go together? I'm engaged, actually. Yes.
I'm engaged to be married soon, hopefully this year or next year.
Yes.
We are in the process of kuongelesha wazazi vizuri. Yes. But yeah, I mean, it's possible with someone who's understanding, because now you see the working hours are difficult. Naroka 5 a.m. unarudi nyumbani saa 6 za usiku. And that's like almost every day of the week if it's a busy project, you know. Kuna temu umekatu home una kazi, you know.
So ukipata mwanamke,
unyaelewa hizi mambo ni shida, but
nishida,
luckily I have someone who understands all these things.
And she supports me vizuri sana. Finds a good thing.
Exactly.
Wewe bora umepata hiyo nyingine itajitatua.
Exactly.
Thank you for joining me today, Mr.
Thank
General.
You very much for
I really, really appreciate
Thank
it.
Thank you for having me.
Usijali, tunaenda mbali.
Tunaenda mbali.
Tuko
hapo njiani. Hata kwa unaenda mbali.
Ay, sana. Yes. Yes, thank you for joining me today. I was your host, Redempta Oburu, and today I was joined by Gerald. Your second name in Anipatianga?
Langiri.
Gerald Langiri.
Yes.
Be sure to join me same time next week for this and more of our Kenyan artists. Goodbye.